Hello and welcome to Education at SSBJ. In the previous video tutorial, we were studying about microorganisms, how are they friendly and how are they harmful. So we shall continue the same chapter further. We have learned that microorganisms are very, very small, which cannot be seen. And that's why man in early days was ignorant about them. He was not knowing about microorganisms. But he could convert milk into curd. Now we know that it is because of a microorganism called Lactobacillus. Early man even knew about making alcohol. But then now we know that it is a carbohydrate, which means a starch and sugar, is converted into alcohol or acid. And who converts that? It is actually converted by microorganism. And the entire process is called fermentation. You must have seen a kneaded flour, that is dough, may get fermented overnight. And when the properly fermentation is over, then the dough gets more smoother, softer, it rises. Why? Because these microorganisms releases carbon dioxide there due to chemical reaction. And since the carbon dioxide is in the form of gas, it will try to go out through the pores of the dough. And that causes the dough to rise. Humans have suffered from various diseases like cold and fever. Now we know these are all because of microorganisms. So microorganisms play a great role in our life. In 1665, Robert Hooke developed a crude microscope. And what does crude microscope mean? Not so much improvised. Not like what you have seen in our laboratories nowadays. But Robert Hooke was the first man who discovered a cell more precisely. Robert Hooke saw a cell wall in the cork tissue. And it actually looked like a different chambers which are adjacent to each other. So since it looks like as many chambers placed beside each other, and the name for chamber is a cell. Generally we use that cell is for a small room, right? So that is why that name is given, cell. But it was a Leeuwenhoek who could use his improvised magnifying glass. In the year 1676, and he saw more clearly, and even he has drawn the diagram of some of the microbes, and he was the first man to start with the study of microorganisms. There are many types of microorganisms. Some are useful and some are very dangerous. They harm us. That is why this chapter deals with useful microorganisms and the microorganisms which are harmful. Among the microorganisms, sometimes we consider a virus also. But viruses are like parasites. And what do you mean by parasites? Parasites stay in some cell, in someone's body, and then only they start growing and multiplying. So virus is one such thing. It doesn't have any identity when it is alone. It dies on its own. But the moment it enters into somebody's cell, living cell, and that living cell may be a cell of a bacteria, right? Or a human being, or a plant cell, there it starts multiplying. So since this virus multiplies like a living being, right? And it doesn't do any other characters, it shows any other characters like a living organisms. So it is in between living and non-living organisms. That's why we are here not considering virus as a microorganism, though it is microscopic. You must have heard HIV, right? This is very harmful virus, and so it is called pathogenic. Pathogenic means a virus which causes disease to us. So what is the full form of HIV? Human immunodeficiency virus. So the word tells you that it is an immunodeficiency. The immune system, the protection system of our body reduces, or it becomes almost zero when this virus affects us. So that means we invite every other diseases if this one virus attacks us. It attacks every part of our body. We suffer from tuberculosis, pneumonia, and tumors, okay, chronic diarrhea, and so many things. Every part of our body is affected. So point to be noted here, though it is a microscopic, it is not considered among microorganisms or microbes, right? Okay. As we have discussed that Anton von Leeuwenhoek was the first person known to have observed bacteria under magnifying glass, right? So remember, bacteria is a plural word, but if there is one bacteria, it's a singular, we call it as bacterium. Since then, thousands of species of bacteria have been identified. Bacteria are one called microbes or microorganisms. Bacteria are of different shape. So depends upon the shape, bacteria is categorized into three categories. As we have already studied that microorganisms are four types. They are, the first one is bacteria, the second one is fungi, the third one is protozoa, and the fourth one is algae, right? And in the previous video we have seen all these, we have discussed in brief about this, but in detail we will go now one by one. And first one is bacteria. And as I have already told, that bacteria is categorized into three types, depends on the shape. The first one is rod shape. Some bacteria looks like rod, and that is called bacillus. Okay, if one bacteria of rod shape is there, it is called as bacillus, and if there are many, it's a plural, bacilli. It doesn't use oxygen to live, so it is called anaerobic bacteria. And where is it found? It's found in the soil and in the water. And some of these bacteria are not so good friends of human, and some are okay with human. Since human is born along with this bacteria, people say there are as many as bacteria, or sometimes more bacteria cell than the cells of our own. The second type of bacteria is a spherical shape. We have studied now rod shape. Now the second one is spherical shaped. Okay, it's called coccus, and the plural is cocci. Remember, plural is cocci. It's like a ball, you know. And this type of bacteria is a pathogen. Now again, what are pathogens? Disease causing microorganisms are pathogens. And interestingly, this type of bacteria is there in our mouth, is there in our intestine, right? But why it doesn't affect us? It definitely affects us. When our resistance power comes down, when our food intakes becomes very low, if we don't do any exercise, if the number of such bacteria are more, and then it starts affecting us. It may cause a skin disease. Okay. Gastrointestinal disorder. Right? So this is about a spherical or ball shaped, right, type of bacteria. It is a pathogen because it's a disease causing. Right? Many type of diseases like skin diseases, food poisoning, all that can happen. The third one is Vibrio, or Vibrio you can call it as. It's just like a hair, you know. So that's why it is ciliated. You can read there, ciliated, just like a hair it is. And this is more common in undercooked seafood. So we must be very careful, because if you consume undercooked seafood, it may cause a diarrhea, abdominal pain, vomiting, and so many other problems. So the next type of bacteria is a spiral shaped. The shape is like a spiral one. The plural is spirilla. It is a coiled type, right? And some of these type of bacteria are pathogens, and they cause disease like syphilis, a kind of a sexual disease, and a skin disease. So here we have completed about bacteria. So once again, to summarize, microorganisms, four categories, right? And again in the bacteria, four categories. But important three categories are bacillus, rod shaped, coccus is a spherical or a ball shaped, Vibrio is a comma shaped, and what is one more type of shape? That is a spiral shape, which is just like a coil, right? Make notes here, and see you in the next video. with fungi, protozoa and algae. And after that we shall start discussing on textbook questions. Thank you very much. Stay strong, stay healthy.